Hello, my name is Sergey Lerik, and today we are exploring procedural terrain generation, specifically generating height maps based on Perlin noise. I'm going to use the Defold game engine with the Lua language, but the methods described in this video are applicable to almost any game engine. One day, browsing Defold forums, I came across a topic in which someone was asking for help generating some terrain with Defold. I decided to help and quickly fixed the issues in the code and showed how to generate a terrain image properly. However, procedural generation is such a fun topic, I couldn't help myself and decided to make a small project with it. I want to make a climate change animation, simulating different climate periods on some planet. First, I set up a procedure to draw an image with code in Defold and show it on the screen. To generate the terrain, I'm using Perlin noise with a common trick to make it look better. Apply several Perlin noises at different frequencies to add better details. The resulting value of the noise is the height of the terrain at the given point. Here's how it looks with a single frequency, and here how it looks with three frequencies. Higher frequencies with smaller amplitudes are adding fine details to the image. To display different environments like water, sand, grass, rocks, we can use the height value and assign different height ranges to different environments. Bottom values from 0 to something like 0.4 could be water. After that, to 0.5, it could be sand, then grass, and finally rocks. I was experimenting with different values and found a combination that I like. At the moment, I'm using solid colors to fill the image, but we can improve it a little. For the water, I've added a small noise using the same noise texture, but at much smaller scale. Gave it a little horizontal stretch, and now it looks more like an ocean with waves. I decided not to animate the waves. It's important to stop while you can. With the water done, I also want to improve the look of the actual heights. Give it some distinction and depth. To do so, I am going to implement a basic lighting. Even though the image is flat as a mat, we have all these cool height values. From the height values, we can compute normals, and from normals, we can calculate lighting in the shader. Here is the code to calculate normals. Basically, take a few values around the given point and calculate their horizontal and vertical difference. Convert into the vector and write it as a pixel to the normal texture. Here's how the normal map looks. Beautiful colors. That's what I call a VFX artist art. I think I should frame it and put it on a wall. A few quick calculations in the shader, and we have highlights and shadows, even though the image is still flat. Now everything seems to be ready to actually make what I want, a climate change animation. Let's start with everything covered in water. Then the water level drops and reveals some rock formations. With time, there's life. It comes to the shores as green plants and produces some beautiful sand beaches. After that, let's add a sprinkle of an ice age. I have an additional shader parameter, coldness, and I can tween its value to simulate winter or an ice age. After the ice age, the planet begins to heat, and it doesn't stop heating until all the water is vaporized and all life goes extinct. Leaves us with this beautiful, lifeless, scorched terrain. Oh, I just figured out I can animate the sun position. Let's make it move a little around our planet. So, finally, here is the result. hope you enjoyed this little project of mine. Please like and subscribe. The code for this project you can find on my GitHub page. The link is down below. And please consider supporting me on Patreon. Thanks for watching.